Excellence is a habit, not a one-off action. Success comes from habits that are implemented consistently. My name is Catherine Gahu, and I'm an entrepreneur. I've spent many years speaking to professionals and business groups on matters to do with branding and marketing. One of the questions that I've received many times is, what success habit can we adopt to achieve exponential growth in our lives, career, or business? In the next few minutes, we are going to talk about success habits for exponential growth. I like the definition of success that focuses on enjoying the journey as well as the destination. Sometimes people are so focused on the destination that they fail to enjoy the journey as they get there. This approach encourages you to celebrate the small wins along the way so that whatever win that takes you forward and enables you to build momentum is something that you appreciate and express gratitude. Whatever small win you make is something you should appreciate and express gratitude about. It will make it possible for you to make the next step and the next step, because the momentum you build is what enables you to take massive action towards the final goal. Exponential growth means increasing in multiples, double doubles. There is a famous Christian song that talks about double double, that blessings come in double double. I like that song because it actually shows the singer, whoever created that song, does know something about the possibility for exponential growth. The unfortunate example that we are using today to express exponential growth is that of the spread of coronavirus. It spreads with a multiplier effect. It actually uses the theory of exponential growth. The habit number one that I want to talk about is keep learning. That may sound quite simple, but the truth is you never get to truly master life or business. Anytime you think you have full control of a subject or anything, something changes. The world is dynamic, always changing. The only way to keep growing is to keep learning. Keep abreast of the changes that take place in your industry and modify your approaches to suit the new circumstances. Someone once said that in life, you either accept change or change will change you. Does that sound familiar? When you fail to prepare for change that is affecting your industry, the environment just sorts you out. Let me quote the Bible here. The Bible says, people perish for lack of knowledge. But I would like to go a little further and remind you that the Bible also says that knowledge without action is dead. Oh, some people tell me that's not exactly in the Bible, that the Bible talks about something else. But I paraphrase, because the Bible says, faith without action is dead. And I believe I can also say, knowledge without action is dead. People talk about the number of books they have read. They talk about the courses they've attended. And most of all, they talk about the diplomas and the degrees that they have earned. But as they say during conferment of diplomas and degrees, you are given the power to do all that which appertains to that degree. In my view, knowledge is potential power until you activate it. There is a song that is sung by women from Kiambu when they have celebrations. It doesn't matter what they are celebrating, they will sing this song. It's called Huthia Switch. It says, Huthia Switch. Basically meaning, touch the switch. It's an acknowledgement that the energy can be available, but until you have the courage to touch the switch or turn on the switch, you will have no power. That is, you can have benefits, you can have gifts, you can have talents, but until you turn the switch, you will not activate. So action is critical in utilizing knowledge. Action generates momentum. You should use new knowledge that is acquired to change something or to improve a process, improve interactions or outcomes. You can enhance your approach or methods. You can change how you relate to people, how you relate to your customers, your employees, or even your family. Use your knowledge to achieve something. The third success habit to activate exponential growth is to optimize what you have. That is the resources you already have. Don't focus on what you do not have. This is very common. We tend to focus on what we do not have. The truth is, you never have everything you need in order to get started. Resources are always scarce when compared to our needs. And even when you want to start something, the perception of what you require sometimes is more than you really need. And you're going to find out only if you start making effort towards it, that's when you realize that you already had enough to move forward. You need to take full advantage of what is working for you. You always have something going for you, always. If you dig deep in your heart, you will find something that is working for you. It could be your skills. Maybe you are the most skilled person in your area of study. Or maybe you are the best person in making a certain item. You could be the best artist. The other common asset that we sometimes forget is you could have the benefit of networks. Maybe you just, you know, a few people who are critical to achieving that which you desire to do. When I talk about skills, skills represent know-how. And networks represent know-who. That is, who do you know who can help you in achieving that which you desire to achieve? And know-how is, what do you know? So the what and the who, when combined, they give you great advantage in actually activating your exponential growth. These are the most important resources in starting a business or pursuing growth in your life, career, or business. When I started my business, I had no money at all. Though I looked like I had some, I leveraged the knowledge I had. When I successfully sold my first business, my client, a Mr. Rogers, who was marketing director at a major bank, shook my hand and said with a serious tone, "Let's get started." I realized that though I was excited about making this sale, there was no way I could raise the money that I needed to deliver to the client's satisfaction. There was no way I could deliver the promise that I'd made to the client. I struggled to sleep that night, but when I woke up in the morning, I made a decision. I booked an appointment with the client to discuss the modalities of setting up the project. So I said, "I'm ready to proceed as agreed, but I have one challenge. I recently came back from America and I don't have the money to progress the project the right way." Then I paused and the silence went on for quite a while. But when he spoke, he approved a 50% down payment for this project. This is how I started my business many years ago. The truth set me free. And to this day, I keep telling people that do not focus on what you do not have. Focus on what you have. And take step by step. Deal with an issue when you get there. You don't have to know the whole picture. It's like the way we drive on the road at night. You cannot see your destination. You only see maybe a few meters from where you are. But you continue because you know the road will take you to where you're going. And the lights continue unfolding the next few meters, the next few meters. And at the end, you get to your destination. So never stop at anything without having utilized optimally all the resources that you already have. Never say that this is not enough until you have fully utilized the other resources that you have. Because if I had taken that route, that was a business that I would not have even approached. Thank you for watching this video. If you have learned something of value, do two things. First, press the subscriber button to subscribe to this channel and act on one of the lessons that you have learned. Take the first step and see how it helps you build momentum to move forward to where you want to go. Before I close, I have a question for you. What action will you take in the next few days to activate your knowledge? Thank you very much. See you next time.